once this law is passed, all our chances of acquiring loans from foreign banks will be the end. Therefore, this law becomes fatal.
The new Tenant Landlord Bill 2026 to prohibit landlords and property administrators from charging rent in dollars or any other foreign currency, since many of them obtain loans from foreign banks in dollars. He explains that given the ever-depreciating value of the Uganda shilling, charging rent in shillings will shrink their profits.
The bill goes further to say that immediately it comes into effect, all landlords will not be able to charge their rental incomes into dollar. This is fatal because it is going to cripple the economy.
Kalungi further asserts that the bill is very discriminatory and seems to give more power to the tenants than the landlords.
Section 1 of the bill stipulates, and I quote verbatim, that the Minister of Finance will be given powers to exonerate some high-profile members of the community. This is fatal, discriminatory, and unconstitutional. We don't know how the minister will exercise his powers to choose some landlords and give them an exemption from this law.
There is a shift of power that has been moved from the landlord to the tenant. The tenant has been protected more, leaving the landlord who owns the property at that. That limits the right to property under Article 26 of the Constitution. It has already been espoused that the bill as well is discriminatory, as it does not cater for the people in a balanced manner, the landlord and the tenant.
These have vowed to do anything in their capacity to block the enactment of this bill should Parliament ignore their plea to drop it.
If this bill is passed in its current format, without taking into account our considerations, we shall have no choice but to proceed to the Constitutional Court to challenge this bill. And I call upon all Ugandans, landlords, and also tenants who can see that this is really unfair to join us in this journey.
The new bill seeks to force landlords to charge their rent in Uganda shillings. The same bill also stipulates that if a landlord is to evict any tenant, they first have to obtain a court order from the High Court, which according to the building owners is very unfair given the slow rate at which courts of law dispose of cases. The bill also requires that landlords reduce rent if some items in the agreement, such as furniture, are not provided.